are already one pick in. We have indeed no Chen, no Enigma, and also some greens getting removed.
I think this is about the most standard you could ban against each of these teams. Like, you ban out puppies, Chen, Enigma.
It's like the first game to test the waters, you know, seeing what the other team's going to throw at them.
Again, it's a long series, so I think if you just want to try to figure out what each team has in store, that this is probably the best way to go about it, because it's just like, you're banning their comfort zone, basically. Team
secrets. I guess that's a bit different. Team Secret going for a lion first?
That's also a pick we probably should have mentioned as contested, because both teams actually value this more than any other team in the tournament, I think. Especially Secret have played this a lot. Probably Pylite Ice, standout hero for the entire tournament. Multiple games, he was probably the MVP with this hero. Yeah. So Secret aren't scared of first face picking and giving Liquid information. They are just that good.
I've heard a Lion described today as that little shitty hero that always creeps through the draft, that is always in every team fight, always able to disrupt anything you do, but never really gets rewarded with the first pick or first ban because it's Lion. But he has had an amazing impact this game, especially on Pylite Ice.
Oh. Someone is right.
There's your first face Phoenix.
Yeah, first face Phoenix. I mean, this is kind of like...
They picked it instantly, too.
Yeah,
because they knew that Secret would ban in the second phase, like you mentioned, so if you want it, just grab it in the first phase. And it's very hard to ban Phoenix in your first phase for bans.
So far, no major surprises. We've seen both of these teams play these heroes before. Anything that you can say from a Beastmaster ban there? Because so far, it feels like... They're just really, both teams just really not want to give anything away. Is that what's happening here?
Secret has played that hero a lot on Misery, and it's been very good as a go-to for them when he doesn't get Prophet. I think his three most picked heroes this tournament are probably Prophet, Beastmaster, and Tide.
Lone Druid maybe?
I think Lone Druid.
He played Lone more than Tide? He played three Tide games.
Yeah, actually, this tournament, maybe Lone Druid is like number four for him. Yeah Tide is...
Did Team Liquid exclusively play support Phoenix? Through here. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. I mean... Darkseer, Void, both really good for Secret. Obviously, Darkseer is better for Liquid right now, but...
With the Phoenix, probably you want Void more. I think it's much stronger with the Phoenix. 5 seconds
remaining. Well, do you guys like the first phase OD?
I think it's good, especially into Invoker. It's a good matchup for OD. The Quasic Sword Invoker obviously relies on Forge Spirits in the lane, and you just two-shot them with Arcane Orb.
I think it has a lot to do with the fact that the first three bans are all pushing heroes, like, well, three out of four. Air Spirit's the only exception, for obvious reasons, but I think in a lineup where the tempo for tower control isn't going to be super fast, it's mostly just going to be small skirmishes, that OD is much better. In a situation where you're, like, letting a Chen through and then you get, like, five man because they're going to push a tier one, OD is really bad in that situation.
Well, Secret is really thinking about this, this last ban, as well as, of course, the pick that comes after this, which will also be theirs. Which
like
hero could they
Void,
be baiting?
Banning Void and picking Darkseer just seems like a really solid choice here. It takes out, the Ursa.
Huh. The pick that isn't that weird?
They're
on Dire, and they're up against Supernova, so...
But Ursa's so good at killing Roshan even if you are on Radiant, right? It takes like a minute or less.
Does it mean the OD might be safe lane?
It could be, yeah.
Yeah. Because it's weird, right? I don't know, I just find it really weird, like, because they could have just gone for it for themselves. Like, the team fight is coming up for Secret right now, the Tide plus OD.
I mean, the thing is about their team is they already have the hero that can help them kill Roshan, like, OD does a tremendous amount of damage, and they can do, I think it was EG who ran the Tidehunter and then Ursa together, and they basically just walked into the pit when he had, like, a Morbid Mask, or maybe it was Mask of Madness, and the Tide was 6, and they just killed it, and there was nothing that you could do about it.
I mean, I just find it weird because Ursa could be really good versus what Liquid have.
Yeah, but Secret don't play Ursa. That's the thing. It's not a Jackie Mao hero.
Are you gonna save
not
Jackie
a late
Mao
game,
hero
not a late game carry.
Not a Rapier carrier either. You definitely can't buy Rapiers on Ursa.
I think Secret pick... They pick Eternal Envy's hero last in almost every single draft. So... Yeah, there's a void. That's the ban I was expecting. It's because it's a Liquid go-to, it has really good synergy with their picks, and I think that hero is actually... You know, it's a little bit special when it comes to OD, because OD can astral someone inside the chrono, but at the same time, getting the chrono on that key target in OD, if you get that hero just fairly low during the chrono, the hero has very little, you know, reset potential. Other heroes can get out and then go back in, but if you've caught the OD and got it low, it has to stay and fight, and then you just finish it off with whatever you have. So.
But why didn't they ban the void? I think, like...
I'm surprised.
I don't know. I think the Ursa was, like, a question mark. I'm not sure what was going on. Like, the void was a hero that would fit their lineup very well, so I don't know. Like, what do you think, Drasko? What could be the reason?
It's more because at this point, if Phoenix is obviously going to be support, right, because they have Void already. They needed a mech carrier, and I don't think that Void's that hero. And if they want to try to just have the mass team fight and bully Liquid and make sure they can get Roshan that way because they don't have a team that's necessarily amazing at kill speed, then that part kind of makes sense. And also the fact that they're pretty much guaranteeing that this is an Xor and Evoker when you pick Void with it, right? I mean, you can go for Quaswex, but they're going to lack a lot of single target damage if they do that. I think they're actually going to have a damage issue. I think.
Gyrocopter!
Yeah, they could go for the Matumba Man Gyro. That would supplement their lineup quite nicely.
If they would have a Gyrocopter, who would you favor in terms of team fight?
It's hard to say. They function in very different ways.
There's the Gyro.
Well, it's still a big team fight hero as well, so it looks like Liquid... Yeah.
It's a good pick.
No, but it was clear that their lineup needed some supplementation inside of Kronos here besides just a Phoenix Egg, you know?
I think this is actually a better pick than Gyro right now. Gyro is good against Enchantress in lane, but Witch Doctor is good against Enchantress in general. It's... When you look at Secret and their picks, it's probably a support Enchantress being run by Puppy, so you want to have someone who can deal with the creeps early on and just prevent him from bullying the lanes. There's the ban. So Liquid made the choice. They probably expected that the Gyro ban would come out, but they value the ability to control the Enchantress higher than the teamfight they could get from this pick. So what do they go to for Matumba when he doesn't get Gyro when they play this teamfight strat? Because that's been the number one pick for them as far as that
goes. I think against teamfight composition... No, I think Juggernaut might also be... Ember could be good later, but if you want to fight early, I think Juggernaut might be better because the spin is really good versus the type.
Just has really bad synergy
and
with Void.
And versus Enchantress as well.
Jagger's really messing. There's the fish man.
And V-Slark, we've seen that before.
They have very good team fight, very good late game, like super good late game with OD and Slark. And
I think their team fight's actually really weak. No. Like, I think a different team, let's say, could have put Invoker in a safe lane, put Death Prophet in mid, and then just push him down very, very early on. I think their lineup's actually super, super greedy.
But they have Enchantress, like, you're talking about Seeker, right?
Yeah.
I think Enchantress can compensate for the early game. And once Enchantress buys enough time, you have enough levels and farm. Like, with Enchantress, I think you should be able to have at least some sort of early game advantage because the hero just wins you the early game, like the laning phase.
I would definitely not recommend Jugger right now. I don't think
it sucks. Versus...
the Liquid Necro.
Okay.
So Andy, they have a lot of heals.
Are you still on the Liquid hype train?
I'm gonna stick to my guns. I actually do like Liquid's draft quite a bit. I think if they let the game go too late, though, it could be very difficult for them, and it's gonna heavily rely on spheres in order for them. And, like, obviously, Reaper Scythe is gonna be a factor too. But this is what they did when they couldn't get any other form of sustain as well. They picked the Necrophos, so they actually had some pushing potential. And, like, since Juggernaut's just not very good with sphere. So,
anybody gonna hop on the train with him?
Yeah, I'm with Liquid this time. I think their team fight's far superior. I think there's way too much pressure on the Enchantress to win all three lanes for them.
Winter and Sin, why are you favoring Secret in this one?
I
think it's pretty even, actually.
Okay.
I think that Enchantress should be able to create enough space for them, and Secret should be able to have a sizable advantage going into the
game. I'll see Secret too, so we're 2 deep.
Okay, we are gonna find out who is gonna get that one game advantage here in the first game of the Grand Finals here. Best of 5, Team Liquid versus Team Secret with Capitalist and Blitz.
Thank you, Shiver. That's right. We're here in the Mercedes-Benz Arena with our grand final between Team Secret and Team Liquid. A mixture of old and new, as led by Puppy, Team Secret face up against Puppy's old teammate, Kuro, who's leading the rising Liquid, who have made the long journey here from qualifiers through lower bracket to finally ending up here in the grand finals.
Yeah, and Secret is a team, too, that a lot of people didn't expect to see them in this top two position. They were plagued by a lot of troubles coming into this tournament. A lot of pros didn't really have them listed as their top three. But that veteran leadership can never be understated, and that's what's going to matter here in this series. Mentality is going to play supreme, just because both lineups have kind of the lineups that they want. Like, these are all heroes that we've seen before from them. it really seems like both teams are just kind of like giving up. Go ahead, take your signature style, and if we can beat it in game number one, that's going to be a huge win and lead this series off to the right kind of mental start.
Yeah, I think tempo is huge in this series because you develop your own internal best of five, and when you start, okay, our lineup was better than yours, we both got the lineups that we wanted, it's going to be you that has to adjust. So this first game, I think, will determine quite a bit, especially for a team like Liquid, who don't have a lot of veterans on their lineup. Kuro and Fada, arguably, but the other three, it's their first Valve-sponsored event. Seth, Jerax was with MVP Hot 6.
Yeah, he's the one who may have a bit more experience than some of the other amateurs, but they definitely come a long way from amateur to semi-pro now. Definitely professionals here at Mercedes-Benz Arena. We already have a good start here for Liquid as Mind Control has managed to counter the laning ward laid out by Team Secret. Already has that extra 100 experience. Our mid matchup is going to be Fada's Invoker versus Weeha's OD. Of course, Mind Control on the Faceless Void up against Eternal Envy Slurk and Pileidai's Lion, who's been a legend so far in this tournament.
Yeah.
Misery will be playing the Tidehunter up against a tri-lane of Phoenix, Witch Doctor, as well as Matumba Man's Necro. That is definitely a Liquid specialty.
And you're going to see the Wild Wing Ripper start the tornado in this mid lane, try to help out Wii as much as they possibly can. This has been the theme of Secret's drafts, is to try to help out Wii, get him a good start. We saw what he could do with his Invoker in the game against Liquid originally. And Puppy's rotations are going to determine quite a lot for them as that top Mind Control gets gone on, but immediately going to time walk himself away.
As the levels progress, he's really going to have to be careful. But at bottom lane, we do have Kuro, who's going to be body blocked up by Misery. Puppy's going to join him. They still have the net ready to go. He's holding off on it. Now controls Kuro, and this could very well be our first blood as Misery stays ahead and snags that last hit for a first blood.
Kuro's got to be careful. Walking up that hill, the Enchantress had the perfect creep for him ready. Even Weeha coming over to participate, but not the kind of start that you wanted if you're Team Liquid. This is a lineup that was determined around the laning phase, as Eternal Envy jumps forward, just trying to get Mind Control out of XP range.
Yeah, they're really going to abuse that long cooldown of Time Walk at level 1. If they can force it out early, they know they can play very aggressive and just keep him out of lane. Still hasn't picked up that level 3, maybe with the 2-minute rune? Nope, that's going to be denied by the Wild Wing Ripper.
Puppy is doing so much right now. Puppy's controlled both runes at the same time using his creeps. A lot of foresight there, and he's got complete control of this bottom half of the map right now.
Yeah, with these illusions and still controlling that Dark Troll Summoners. Now he's actually got a Satyr Tormentor, who's been another favorite of this tournament. They can actually just push up against these two supports and give Misery some space.
That's exactly what they need, especially since Tide, this tournament has not worked out well when you've just completely sacked this hero. Plus you have an Enchantress who's going to be taking control of that camp that you naturally want to go to. He's going to have to find some farm independently of that.
And it really feels like Liquid, more so than other teams, really try and pressure the offlaner and keep him out of experience for as long as possible. It seems like they run much more of these full defensive tri-lanes than others.
Yeah, they're the only team this tournament so far that I think hasn't gone to a jungler whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
You saw Kuro do it in the early group stages, but it seems like they just favor it, having the strong lane set up into snowballing into some kind of push.
Mind Control is actually going to try and do a little jungling here, though he doesn't have the Iron Talon just yet, so it's going to be a slow progress for him. Going to be end up falling behind, perhaps, Misery, as he's been getting a lot of spaces now, level 3.5.
Yeah, this absolutely can't happen for Liquid, just because the level 6 timing of Secret is going to determine a lot. I don't really know how much counter-initiation they're going to have. They do have the heal of Matumba Man and the Witch Doctor, but early on it might not come into play so much.
Matumba Man is going to be gone on now. They just want to get some damage out. Not sure if they can actually finish him off, as they do have a paralyzing cast that's going to help control the Centaur Conqueror and allow Matumba Man to retreat with minimal damage done. But this mid lane is definitely where Liquid seem to be coming out on top right now, as despite the Wild Wing Ripper having such a big impact with those tornadoes, we still have a large CS lead for Fada.
Once the lane gets a few more levels, the OD will do just fine, just because he can kill the Forge Spirit so quickly by himself. But at top, Mind Control's gonna get gone on. He's gotta be careful. If he gets hit, he's gonna run out of mana, but manages to get the time walk off before.
Meanwhile, the double damage is quickly grabbed by the Witch Doctor in that bottom lane.
Puppy has had so much impact in this game already. It's made Matumba Man quite afraid to go on this Tidehunter, who's already picked up 14 CS, and the reason why this is so big is this is almost exclusively from the lane. He's already got the Arcane Boots, and much faster than they wanted it.
Even at the top lane, PyliDai, now that he no longer has to worry about zoning out the Faceless Void as much, is level 3 due to the fact that he's been kind of pulling and also just farming up some of the neutral camps by himself. He's going to rotate over and just give OD a nice mid ward that might see some support rotations across.
Yeah. The tournament so far, Jerax has been playing the Roamer or the Phoenix, and the difference between two is when you play the Phoenix, you're a little bit more static. You want to be that lane support, get kind of annoying. You really need levels though. Whereas usually when he plays like Tusk or Earth Spirit, you see him rotate around quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
That's not really going to happen in this game. And because the Witch Doctor stun is so slow, oftentimes we should be able to get the Astral Imprisonment off and TPs can follow. So there's not going to be a whole lot of mid presence for Liquid until maybe they get the level 6 on the Faceless Void, but he's falling behind in levels. Overall, I'd say things have gone pretty well for Secret. They do have to apply some mid pressure though to this Invoker. He's getting a lot more than this OD.
Yeah, if they could actually successfully gank up the Invoker, it feels like at that point Team Secret will have won every single lane. Weeha does have his level 6, of course, no love on the ultimate just yet, but he is still a right-clicking powerhouse. They're actually going to go up to the top lane, it seems, and try and get a gank on Mind Control. They're going to force out the Time Walk. Eternal Envy is setting up this gank. Now if Mind Control comes forward, he won't have that Time Walk up. And sure enough, PyliDai leads with a Hex. He's going to be able to jump onto him and control Mind Control long enough for the kill to go to Eternal Envy.
Really well set up by Team Secret. I thought for a second that Eternal Envy had jumped the gun, but leading with the pounce makes it so that Mind Control thinks, oh, there's nobody else here, he's just doing this.
Oh man, Misery just runs down that Phoenix.
How did he
level
do that
three
by himself?
He's got the upgraded boots, and unfortunately, the Phoenix is just a little bit too late with that Icarus dive.
I'm so surprised.
Yeah, that
leading
never
phase
should have happened. Perhaps a little nerves giving to Jerax on his signature hero.
They have to calm down right now, slow down the internal pace. Too many heroes are struggling right now around the map, and you absolutely should not be losing a support, especially in a tri-lane situation. It gives so much confidence to the offlaner. Misery, who's already gone, this might be the most I've ever seen a Tidehunter get in a major game versus a straight-up tri-lane.
Yeah, he's almost level 6 by minute 7. And as some of these creeps die underneath the tower, he should be able to pick that up. That opens up more opportunities for Secret to make a rotation to the bottom lane, as they can now lead with a Ravage.
Yeah. Eternal Envy getting a lot of farm on that Slark, courtesy of that tower, but you don't want to see Eternal Envy get farmed if you're Liquid.
It seems to be pretty problematic with Liquid not having a Roamer. They can't actually upset some of these other lanes, and losing out kind of on their safe lane with Misery getting so much farm. It seems like Team Secret are going to go into that 15-minute point and feel very confident about their lead.
No, they're going to be incredibly comfortable right now. Plus the fact that the Void hasn't gotten nearly enough this game so far. Liquid are a team that we've seen repeatedly rely on just the ability to 5-man, but if your laning phase doesn't go well and you would try to attempt to do that, your window of opportunity gets really small.
Bot is actually doing a bit of jungling here as the Invoker just now picks up his level 8. But such aggressive vision from Team Secret is scouting all of this out. Looks like this is about time for Team Liquid to reinforce with some obs. They've got 3 different obs wards on the courier ready to go. They are going to try and make a rotation with Eternal Envy to catch out Fada. You know he's been farming this for a while. Eternal Envy's going to try and lead with the pounce, but unfortunately his vision, if Fada's able to scatter it up pretty damn quickly, they'll just kill the Forge Spirits and take one of the small neutrals, but nothing of major recourse for Team Liquid.
Yeah, still the entire laning phase going in favor of Secret. Experience at this phase, just 8 minutes in, is already more than 2,000. Net worth following a similar trajectory. Liquid are losing a lot of map control, and like we talked about, they don't have roamers to be able to fall back on or anything.
And they desperately need their supports to be level 6 in order to have a big impact in teamfights, so right now they're kind of screwed on both ends.
Yeah, and Eternal Envy, if he decides to go for the Shadowblade route, these poor supports on Liquid are going to get even worse, as Witch Doctor struggles really heavily against Slark.
Now, you know that Fada's going for that Midas. It's just kind of standard on Invokers, but how far do you take that? Do you actually consider maybe a greedier build on the Slark? It doesn't look like it, as they're actually going to use the Slark to head down to the bottom lane for a smoke.
Yeah. This is the move that almost everybody on Dire will make. Invade the Radiant safe lane, take down that tower, try to get control of the mid tower as well, get control of the jungle, and allow Misery to just open up this entire map for them. And with the Ravage available, it's going to be really hard for them to defend. Matoma Man should already be gone from this, as Secret have complete control of this jungle right now. Puffy's going to lead the way.
He shows himself at the bottom lane, but Team Secret are not going to try and turn for that one. They're actually going to head mid, looking for some of these supports. Kuro is sitting on the side here. He's going to be the first one to pop this smoke. But Team Secret, I mean, it seems pretty obvious by now.
Yeah, they think it's actually going to be bottom, but this mid rotation,
it's going to kind of catch Liquid by surprise. Kuro's definitely going to be going down here. The TP is not going to be complete by Matoma Man. That was a heavy rotation by Team Secret, only getting a support, but that being said, they'll take early control of this middle tier 1 tower, and that'll kind of open a gateway to controlling the Radiant jungle.
This is going to mess with Liquid's minds. You saw that Matoma Man was hiding behind the tower, the tier 1 at bottom, because that's the expected rotation. It's the safest one, almost every team makes it. But Secret kind of turned it on its head. They decide that they're going to go for the mid tower instead. This tower offers up a lot of control. You notice that Matoma Man even went for the TP, cancels it, but he realizes Secret is committing for this. He already starts making the trek over. You don't want to ever just give up this tower for free.
Matoma Man is a bit isolated, but he's going to join the rest of his team now.
Eternal Envy is just cutting off the spot.
Yeah, he's going to make sure. Now he sees Matoma Man cutting over. He knows this is not a fight that Team Secret necessarily want to be able to take. The heals go down. Misery is here. They can actually fight this one for the Chronos. Here comes in first. They need to be able to pop this one. He's got the Ravage. There goes the egg. They're going to try and pop this one. Team Secret can't fight around that Ravage as the egg was the securing fight.
Oh, are they not going to get anything?
They're really not, unless, oh, Jarek just gets a bit too close, and Tyleidi pounces on that opening.
Liquid did not coordinate that fight nearly well enough. They had the Reaper Scythe available, plus the Death Pulse. You didn't have the level 6 on the Witch Doctor, but Liquid have to coordinate that a lot better, as Mind Control found a perfect setup opportunity, but the egg wasn't quite close enough. And that could have been the opening that they needed, but Secret instead, taking advantage of the first Ravage of the game. Misery's already got a mech.
Misery is quite so bad right far now. Ahead. He's just going to play that bullying position where he's just going to be sitting so far forward. Team Liquid have yet to get a kill on the board.
Slark's going to go for the Midas. He senses that his team is doing okay without him so far, and Liquid just don't have the best ways to kill him when it comes to these individual pickoffs. So what they're going to rely on heavily is these team fights. But Eternal Envy is going to play the split push game. He's going to say, I'm only going to come if it looks like it's a guaranteed fight or my team needs me. But with this 5-0 start and your Tidehunter getting this farm, Secret are so comfortable with what's going on.
Nice deny in the Invis rune by Jarex.
Oh, that egg, if it was just, they're re-showing it on the Chinese stream. Inches forward, but still really well done by Team Secret so far.
Eternal Envy wrapping around this mid lane is going to go for Kuro here. Kuro does have a TP scroll. He's actually going to be able to dodge the bounce, and he casually is just like, nah, I'm just here for farm.
I was just kidding, guys.
Yeah, bottom lane, Matoma Man's going to be in some serious trouble. They come in, are going to be able to hit the Fire Spirits a little bit. They're actually going to try and turn onto Misery, but Matoma Man's all out of mana.
Damage.
They can't actually fight this one. In fact, they're going to be surrounded here as Team Secret. They're going to lead the way with Eternal Envy on behind. Mind Control's going to be the target, but he already has the time walk out. The supports may be left to die here, as Kuro did TP in. Jarex is able to get to TP out, though.
Yeah, I think this is just going to be a dead Kuro. You give up on this tier 1 tower at bottom. There's almost no chance that you're going to be able to defend it out. The Centaur's even going to scout in.
He's going to spot out Kuro soon.
Oh, they're
pinged. They've already pinged him. They know. They've got the stun. Kuro has no hope to be able to get out of this one.
They're going to trade for this tier 1 tower immediately. Call's been made.
They can't even do any sort of counter pushing on the side of Team Liquid. That mid tower was the target of Team Liquid, but it's only down to half HP, and Team Secret, who have already taken the bottom tier 1, are going to start rotating over.
Secret should absolutely defend this. They've got the mech available on the Tide, plus the Ravage. There's almost no chance that Liquid get off a clean fight.
They need 5 more seconds for the mech, but he's ready to go with the Ravage. He can just start booking it forward if he wants.
Yeah. Misery right now, 2-0. Ready as the 5th highest net worth in the game, well ahead of the Faceless Void, who even Tyleidi Dai has eclipsed. And they've got an Ancient Stack ready for him as well. They want to make sure that this Tide propels himself into the core role. Liquid have a tri-core, they want to match it with Secret.
At this point in time, it's looking pretty good for Team Secret. How do you continue to hold this kind of lead? Do you build it and go for, well, they are going to start
going for Roshan. They don't have the typical heroes for it, but I guess Enchantress makes the perfect tank.
It's nighttime, so Eternal Envy is going to have all the vision in the world. Plus, you know that Liquid can't fight into you anymore. Mm-hmm. All of your heroes are way too tanky. I don't think they have the control factor unless they get some sort of sick Chronosphere off.
Looks like they're going to try for it here.
They might be...
Four-man smoke. Witch Doctor's making his way up. Mind Control is actually in a perfect position to be able to get a Chronosphere. He's going to lock it down, but it only catches Misery! The egg goes down on top of it. They're going to try and blow Misery before he gets off the Ravage, but he pops the mech, turns around with the Ravage, and now here comes the full artillery from Team Seeker's arm that he's blown up to. Take out the Tidehunter, but that means nothing, as Team Seeker will sacrifice Misery as long as they can win this fight. Eternal Envy moves forward, pops the open, starts going from a top of men, barely lives through all this, but he should be able to get the kill in the end. Dominating three, and Mind Control, he's almost out of mana. Time walks aside. Puppy's still going to be able to get that vision, though, and Mind Control has little hope to be able to get out of this one. They're going to hold on to the pounce until Mind Control uses his time walk. Walk him down. That's a wipe. Team Secret win the Roshan fight.
Absolutely dominant. Liquid had to contest that. That looked like a good opportunity, but he barely whiffs on the Lion. Team Secret, this is the dream start for them. Liquid walk in as five, get absolutely wiped. This is going to be a free Roshan for them as well. Miha, who was already really farmed, is going to pick up the Aegis for himself. Eternal Envy already up to 3,200 gold. And this five-man team fight lineup from Liquid is just not delivered.
They've even got a bit of Ancient stacking here for the Tidehunter. When he's back up, they can start looking towards a Blink Dagger. And then they'll have that perfect kind of counter-initiation against Mind Control.
It just took them way too much to kill that Tidehunter. They blew the Chronosphere, most of the Invoker's abilities, and the Reaper Sight. And that's what you get when you get such a farmed Tidehunter. That's why Secret continue to allow them to farm around the map.
They only just now picking up the Death Ward. I mean, that's obviously a big addition to this whole team fight scenario for Team Liquid, but... It seems just a bit too late. At 16 minutes in, we're already seeing a 7,500 gold lead for Secret and a 5k experience lead.
And we already talked about it. The Slark is going to be so hard for Liquid to lock down. And in those fights, you saw him go absolutely insane. Eternal Envy, this is the dream game for him. There's a one stun that he has to worry about in the Chronosphere. But once he saw Misery get stuck in it, he was so happy. He said, I'm going to immediately go in. It doesn't really matter. You guys don't have the cores to be able to stop me either.
If he's not the target of this Chronosphere, he is able to do so much damage with this Hand of Midas, Yasha. They are going to be able to catch him here, but he pops the ultimate just in time. They're going to have to wait this one out. They will just barely be able to land the Sunstrike. Follow this up now with the Necrophos ultimate for the save! Comes out from Weehaw! Now the turnaround. It's Team Liquid try and retreat. Mind Control's almost out of mana. Does he able to get a little bit of magic wand charge to time block himself away? Kuro runs himself into the trees. He's hoping to be able to get a TP out at this point. And he will
be able to do so.
Oh no, the heck! Twilight Die on point at the last half second. Nothing is going right for Team Liquid at this point. Mind Control can't even farm.
Even with three heroes there,
oh,
and
he's
going to
run into Misery. The time walks up in one more second. He's going to jump over to the left-hand side, but then Pettis Shot follows him. They're going to be able to get enough vision for Puppy to get one more shot, and that's going to be a killing spree already on Puppy. 18 minutes in. An unbelievable start for Team Secret.
Even with the numbers advantage for Liquid in that area of their jungle, they're unable to do anything. They pretty much just have to ditch the Void and say, see you later, bros. Misery still has the Ravage available. This is going to be a free tier 2 tower. Secret want this. Liquid, they don't have the Chronosphere up. That's their major teamfight ability. And Secret are playing around their Ravage so well right now.
Jesus, a Blink Dagger from a Tumba Man, but right back at you. Pyladai picks one of his own.
Pyladai Lion this entire tournament has only lost one game so far. They're giving so much space right now to both their supports. And the reason they're doing this cap is because they want all five heroes to be online for the late game. Mm-hmm. They want no doubt left for Liquid.
2 minutes to actually use this Aegis. Team Secret, is it actually worth trying to use this Aegis and push down some tier 2 towers, or are they just happy to play the farm game for now?
I think they're incredibly satisfied with just playing the farm game because they know their cores aren't really counterable. What usually happens is if you have the core that scales better in the Slark, you're almost always just going to say, well, none of the pressure's on us. Liquid feel like they have to do something right now, but we've got the Aegis. There's no way that they can contest us either. Mm-hmm. Eternal Envy already has a Mantis style.
And Misery's farming up a gigantic stack.
They're being so efficient on the map. I know the panel mentioned it yesterday, but...
Is it going to be enough? The Reaper Scythe! It doesn't actually hit Pile I Die and deal enough damage to finish him off. So he won't have that 30-second penalty.
I think the panel mentioned it earlier, though. Team Secret have heavily relied on having the better late game. And usually what ends up happening is the early game goes a little bit rough for them, but they manage to pull it through. This is one of the few games in the tournament where I've seen them absolutely destroy in the early game while having the better late game. And it's just been... They've been out team fighting Liquid from start to finish. And they're making so much efficiency out of these stacks, too. But Liquid are going to gather up. This is what their lineup has to do, unfortunately. They just have to keep battling into this Juggernaut.
Which is why you see Eternal Envy go for such more of a farm-oriented, split-pushing style, as this will allow him just to abuse the five-manning of Team Liquid and get the most out of the map.
Yeah, Liquid are going to back up, but they really don't want to. 7,500 in both net worth and NXP.
There you see it, a stat that really tells a bit of the death knell for Team Liquid, the lowest team net worth for the 20-minute marker in this major.
Yeah. Their cores are still keeping up, though. That's the one positive sign right now for Liquid. Like, Secret should not just breathe a sigh of relief quite yet. There is a hand of Midas Invoker that's farming quite a bit. The Necrophos is also taking advantage of the space of Team Secret playing spread out and allowing their Tidehunter to farm. And so in those two regards, they're kind of okay. It's just Kuro's farm and Jerex's farm right now that it's really being eclipsed by the other two supports on Team Secret.
And even if you have the better late game, it's always dangerous to play against a Necrophos with that Reaper Scythe penalty. The late game becomes a bit precarious no matter how solid you think it is.
And Liquid Kuro, are now gathered up in this Secret safe lane. They cannot afford to mess up this fight.
Highlight Eyes ready to go with the initiation. Misery has the follow-up as well. He has a Blink Dagger of his own. Puppy's going to be leading the charge here, seeing if Liquid will take the bait and fight him at all.
This is how unkillable Puppy is. He's Kuro. Just running forward, ice armored.
He knows he's dead. He's caught inside the trees, throws out the paralyzing cast towards the tail end, but that is the end. Team Secret can now actually maybe go for a five-man push at top lane, but either way, whether it's farming or pushing, Team Secret, they're happy with all the net worth they're bringing in. Oh, Slark. Almost got that courier picked off.
Eternal Envy is just showing off at this point. Level 15. They're going to go for this with relative ease, as Liquid are just going to split up around the map and start farming as much as they possibly can. I think they just have to kind of switch gears. Look for some sort of smoke opportunity when the map decides to open up. Secret have shown that they are prone to sometimes making these mistakes when their cores play on opposite sides of the map a little bit too much.
Mm-hmm.
But we saw, like, one time Liquid, they tried to make advantage of that. They used the Chrono mid. It just didn't really lead to anything, as the Slark was able to pop his ultimate before the Chrono.
They better do it now, too, because the OD is about to finish up his BKB, and that's one of those big power spikes that Team Secret's going to be feeling.
Yeah, they're just going to go continue to farm. Secret inherently both their cores.
Matubba Man really shows himself fighters. In the mid lane and immediately starts backing up. And he should too. Eternal Envy's gonna cut in from the side.
Got the
They're
stun.
Gonna be able to get the stun. Matubba Man needs some help from the Sun Ray. They will be able to turn this one around a little bit. Misery pops the Ravage now. Seeing how low Matubba Man is. They definitely want the kill. They'll get it too. The Supernova with the Chronosphere over the top. Maybe this is finally Team Liquid's time to be able to get some kills, but they just can't seem to do enough damage. Once again, Weehaw provides the save with the OD. Ultimate being dropped onto Liquid. They're completely out of mana now. They're still gonna try and turn and fight. Weehaw with the Reaper Scythe being dropped. Weehaw saves Misery live. But he ends up committing his own.
Still, that was a buyback from Matumba Man. If you're Liquid, you've immediately got to start barreling down. There is a buyback available for the OD because of how early this game is. So Liquid at best can get this tier 2 tower.
At the same time, there's going to be no Ravage, no Sanity's Eclipse. Maybe it's best if they just let Team Liquid have this tier 2.
Yeah, Liquid are going to try to make this happen as... They know the kind of situation that they're in. Matumba Man isn't getting a lot of farm. He just continues to get behind. The Slark scaling up, up, up. Witch Doctor can absolutely do nothing against him with 1,000 gold. As Curl's just gonna get gone on, look how quickly he pops him. Nobody from Liquid can do anything to help out.
Eternal Envy already starts building into that Scotty. It's got so much farm. It's impressive that Fada has managed to keep somewhat in step, sitting in second place with 11k net worth, but the rest of his allies are nowhere near that kind of marker.
That's the benefit of having the Midas plus never dying. Like, ever since that first death in the game, he's just been playing really far back, but it doesn't really matter if your Invoker's getting a lot of farm, because eventually your Witch Doctor and your Phoenix, they've got to get something. You can't afford these two to be food, so your control factor in these fights. Something that they have to somehow deal with as well is these Astral Imprisonments are hard countering this Necro.
I like this build. Going back for the pipe here on Misery, he's got the Hood of Defiance, which is still going to be a gigantic upgrade against this Necro post carry.
And works really well against the Invoker as well.
Yeah, so you've got two magic damage cores. Not a whole lot of physical damage on the side of Team Liquid. His mind control is definitely not going to be helping out in that regard whatsoever. He's still continuing to go for the utility route. Has drums, going to start building into the Ags now. Team Secret, though.
I really like this. They showed Pi at bottom, so at top, Liquid, they're not 100% sure where everybody is, and they're being hemmed into their base. They don't have the tier 2 atop. The ward sees them.
They're actually going to try and fight this one, but OD, he's already managed to get off the imprisonment onto himself. Team Liquid managed to fight it out, but coming in from behind, they've already taken out the Invoker. They're going to pop the Supernova as well as the Chronosphere, but they just simply have no damage. Now here comes the Death Ward, and they'll finally be able to kill Weehaw, but Team Liquid need to be able to get out. A Secret are coming in from behind. They've already taken out two. They're going to try and chase down Mind Control as well, while Jarek's quick to get out of the trees he's sitting in.
Yeah, Misery didn't have the Ravage available, but he does have the Blink, and Jarek doesn't have the dive. Puppy's gonna chase this one down as...
15 seconds, trying to slow down the attack speed of Puppy. He needs 12 more seconds. They don't actually care about the Phoenix, it seems. They wanted to be able to chase down Matumba Man, but he's already TP'd out.
You saw Misery thinking about it too. He was like, do I pop the Ravage for this? Nobody was quite nearby enough. He didn't want to risk missing it. Decides not to do it at all, but they do manage to nab the Invoker. He was Liquid's saving grace when it came to net worth. This Slark just continues to build and build. It doesn't really matter for Secret if they lose the OD here and there.
Yeah.
Especially since he's about to get his own BKB. It's Eternal Envy right now that is their main concern.
With his double damage, he should be able to easily take out Roshan. Team Liquid doesn't seem like they do have a couple of smokes, but with Mind Control pushing out mid, it seems like they don't know that Roshan is a possibility.
Yeah, even if it is, they don't have the Phoenix Egg plus Chrono combo that they've been playing around. And it looks like they're making their way over, but...
it's just too late.
You just gotta churn right back around.
Yeah. Go back from where they came. They have Fauna's gonna be stalled up by the Mud Golem, but Team Secret don't really care too much. They back out, they're just going to play the farm efficiency game.
Yeah.
The Scotty is now complete.
Liquid trying to pretend like they're walking it off, like that was just a farming smoke.
We head up to the top lane, go to the off lane camp.
Just like cough it off. Ugh.
It seems like they're hoping that someone is going to TP up to the top lane from Team Secret and they can get the quick pick off there.
Yeah, but with Mind Control showing himself, they know that Secret are going to go for the 5-man themselves.
Yeah.
Now that they've got the Aegis on this Slark. So Liquid are trying to open up the map in other ways. The worst thing they could do that was leave these two backline heroes is Eternal Envy. He knows there's a ward up here, but he doesn't really seem to care.
Just runs right through.
He's got to get out of here.
He's got 2400 HP, but against 5 different heroes, he should still be careful.
Yeah, I don't think they could kill him, but you don't want to just waste the Aegis like that. You want to use it for the 5-man push if you can. Misery is already set up at this bottom lane. Eternal Envy can make his way down there too. Liquid absolutely cannot fight this.
Maybe they can get a pick off on Pileidai though. Mind Control has picked up the Invis rune and is trying to scout some things out. He is going to be scouted though, as this counterward ward combination should be able to see its rotation across. You can see Team Secret are already splitting themselves up, making sure there's not going to be a 3-man Chronosphere if possible.
Yeah, Liquid want to get something out of this.
Ooh,
and Puppy's going to be the target.
He just goes for the solo Chronosphere. This is so dangerous. They have a Sunray. They're going to follow up with the cast. Maybe even drop the Death Ward for this one. Puppy is going to be saved by Weehaw. But he's going to be running back in. Oh, there goes the combination for Misery and Weehaw. They're blowing up Liquid left and right. 3 down, and Kuro, he realizes there's no escape here. Mind Control also trying to time walk himself, hiding in the trees. Ooh, 2 more seconds. He's going to be saved by the imprisonment for now, but they should be able to run him down no matter what. The pounce is going to miss, but still, they've got him with the blink dagger on Weehaw. Kuro's not going to stay ahead of Misery either. This is eventually going to be a wipe, as Team Secret are now well-positioned to push out that bottom lane and think about pressuring high ground.
Secret have absolute control of this game right now. This four-position Puppy Enchantress, it's not the hero that you want to go for. 1300 HP, has the heal. They've got multiple ways to save her with both the mech, the pipe, and the astral imprisonment. I mean, nobody from Secret is a free target at this point.
Absolutely not. Our tier 2 is going to fall, and they're going to continue going high ground. I like this choice from Jerix. Normally we see the Aether Lens, but the choice of the Veil of Discord is a nice addition to all these intel cores.
Still, this mid tower looks like it is going to fall. Liquid don't have the Chronosphere available, and I don't really even know how they set up a fight right now. With the Aegis still on Envy for another 2 minutes, they've got to be careful. This guy hits hard. And he's got 3,200 gold to back him up.
Paralyzing cast. They're actually going to try and go for Puppy here. Sunstrike is going to land. Nice setup there from Vada. And Team Secret will actually back themselves up. They don't have the Ravage. They still have that Aegis. If they wanted to be able to fight, they could do it. And yeah, Eternal Envy's not going to show too much fear. He turns around, dares Mind Control to fight him.
And Kroki's got to be careful. It's by far the easiest hero to kill for Eternal Envy. He's going to get stunned up by the cast, but he sees Kuro.
Maybe he wants to make himself a target since he already blew that Death Ward. Eternal Envy is going to oblige. They're going to be able to double-team Kuro as fast as possible. The Maledict goes down. It's Last Dying Ward Mina on the right-hand side. They're going to try and blow up Weehaw. They're successful, too. They've got the Reaper Scythe.
Oh, the
Phoenix Egg is going to be able to explode as well. Team Secret are going to be caught here. They thought they could turn. They thought that they could fight, but they're going to lose some major heroes here as Misery's just eventually going to be chased down. He's a tanky beast, but there's just no escape for him.
Oh, with the Sunray drop, too.
Four heroes down and Team Liquid, that is the first glimmer of light that we've seen all game for them.
Yeah, didn't really think that was going to be possible, especially with how big Eternal Envy is, but Envy decides this is not the fight that we can take anymore, even with the Aegis. Going to immediately get out of there. He wants to make absolute sure that if his team gets wiped like that, he's not going to go down with them.
I really like the way that Kuro positioned himself forward. I think Team Liquid knew that they just had to take a fight. Otherwise, this game was going to stall out and Team Secret would take full control.
When you're in a situation like this and you're just waiting for lane creeps to come to you, Cap, you're almost always going to fall behind because you've got Secret who are going to farm the same amount of creeps in the lane. And on top of that, they've got both jungles to work with. So you've got to take some sort of fight outside your base. If you allow Secret to just split up and farm like this repeatedly, right in front of you, you're almost never going to be able to catch up.
Liquid are not actually going to go, well, I guess they got the Fairy Fire Spirits and this tower is low enough. They can take this tier 1 without committing any heroes. So a nice little bump up in gold for them.
Yeah, but Eternal Envy, he has the Moon Shards now. One of the best Slark items and awaited for them to deal with the Phoenix Egg.
I like the completed Shivas, though, to help offset some of the attack speed advantage that OD and Slark are so reliant on.
Yeah, this hurts the OD especially. It's one of the best counters that you can get, short of picking a Tidehunter and getting one on himself.
He's going to have a completed Scythe of Ice, though, soon on the OD.
I mean, Secret or not, poor whatsoever in this game. They can continue to scale however they want. They still have a lot of map control afforded to them by the fact that Eternal Envy Slark is so hard for Liquid to lock down. So everybody from Liquid, nobody even bothers heading down here because they can't afford to fail another gank on him. Because as soon as the Chrono's used, Team Secret know, like, okay, this is our timing window, let's go for it again. Fortunately for Liquid, they do have the Chronosphere. So the cooldown of it is dramatically shortened.
So once that, so now that the Aegis is down, do you think that's target number one if they can actually catch him out? No, I guess they have to go for the OD, right? Because the imprisonment.
Yeah, the Astral.
Yeah.
I think it's causing them way too many issues.
So that should allow, as long as they don't both get caught, that should allow Eternal Envy kind of free reign to right-click heroes.
Yeah, I think he has, this is one of the freest Slark games he's going to get in this tournament. There's almost nothing that can really deal with him. He deals with both the cores pretty well. They've only got one hard lockdown in Mind Control's Chronosphere. You're seeing that reflected right now. He's 8-0. He's farming with impunity.
Even Puppy's about to complete an axe. He's been kind of tag teaming with Misery as they make their way through jungle after jungle.
Yeah, that's another thing is that Secret just developed themselves four cores. Puppy, you saw what happens when they try to go on him. There's nothing to deal with the Untouchable from the Enchantress. They had to drop two ults just to try to take him down, and even then they weren't successful. The Axe is going to make him a lot tankier, but even more important, it's going to make him hard to ignore in these fights.
Matumba Man is going to reveal himself in the mid lane, and Liquid are four-man smoke behind, hoping to be able to catch something here, maybe bait him out. Mind Control, though, his smoke pops, and Misery's quick to blink out. A nice read there from Team Secret, position themselves beautifully, and great reactions are not going to be caught.
Yeah, and Puppy's immediately going to TP himself out, too. This is one of the few aggressive moves that I could see Liquid making use of, but everybody has already gotten out of that top lane, and without a Blink Dagger on this Faceless Void, it's so hard to initiate.
Team Secret, they've already drawn the map. They want to fight this one. They're going to head up to the top lane. Team Liquid want to fight. They'll have it. So they're trying to chip down this tier 2 tower. Misery's ready to go. He's going to wait. Waiting on the Ravage. They're going to throw it out now. We'll be able to catch up. Four. That's going to be a beautiful figure of death that pops with Tumble Man as well. Now they've got the... that's going to be an A combination with the Chronosphere that only really catches two. Kerr's going to let out the Death Warp, and there's just not enough damage here. OD drops the ultimate. Jarrus comes back for the egg, but his teammates are all gone. Mind Control's going to try and get himself out with the Time Walk TP away. Should be successful there as... Oh, Violet Eye! Oh, so close.
Puppy absolutely obliterated that BKB Invoker. He just came from behind, prances, and says, one hit, two hit, three hit, you're dead.
So between the combination of nukes, control, and just straight pure damage, both the intelligence cores of Team Liquid just evaporate, and now Team Secret ready to force some buybacks.
Yeah, that was the worst possible fight for Liquid. This is not a fight that they can take anymore, especially without the Phoenix deck available. Eternal Envy still has some of the stacks left over from that top fight, making quick work of the racks.
His attack speed is truly out of control at this point. 9-28, 36 minutes in, our first lane of racks is going to go down for Team Liquid. It's almost a 20,000 net worth lead.
Yeah, and you've got a Hex Secret now completed on the OD. The BKB from the Invoker isn't enough of a defensive item anymore either, as Puppy just cuts through him like butter.
Yeah, if it wasn't clear from that top fight, now with the Scythe of Ice, it means initiation has to go the way of Team Liquid. They don't have a prayer in being able to win a fight unless they're the one starting it.
Yeah, it's probably going to be the next Roshan fight that they take, but they're going to need the best setup possible. The Phoenix Egg is excellent at fighting around that territory. The problem is they just don't have enough control factor to lock anybody down past that.
What is the best fight that Liquid can get while still being realistic?
Okay, that part is the awkward part.
I mean, we could say 5-man Chronosphere, egg on top. You know, they blow up the Slark with Reaper Scythe, but it just seems a little bit unrealistic.
That's kind of how it has to be, though.
Okay.
Like, I don't really know how else Liquid are going to win this fight, just because if you don't catch the Tide plus another core, then the cores just destroy you. If you don't catch Puppy, then he just focus fire and hones in on Fada. And if Fada decides to Ghost Walk, then you already got the Invoker out of the fight, and they desperately need his damage. Secret just have a lot of win conditions backing them up, and Liquid don't have many at all. It's pretty much get a multiple hero chrono that... I guess you could say they could get a 4-man chrono. Highlight Die maybe not be...
But even then, Pi will be able to get some sort of
Pi
disables.
Pi hits, like,
yeah.
Ravages left and right with the Zerg Spike alone. So
he does.
I'm not really sure.
Team Secret, they know this. Oh, Eternal Envy's on the ramp here. Pounce up in 3 more seconds. Gonna pop his ultimate. They actually hit the Chronosphere, but Zerg Puppy goes, they have all this extra damage over the top. The Sunstrike gets laid down, but Misery hits the counter initiation with the pipe over the top. Weeha, blowing up heroes. It's gonna be able to take out two. And again, Liquid, time after time, the initiation comes from Secret. Heroes are immediately lost, and they just have to retreat.
That's the second time Eternal Envy's been able to get his Shadow Dance off during the Chronosphere duration. It's played so well in this game. It helps that Liquid just don't have enough to follow up with it. But mechanically, this is about as good as you want to see Envy play if you're a Secret fan. He hasn't made any unnecessary risks. He's min-maxed this game perfectly.
Now Jackie's going to be able to play even more balls to the wall with the Aegis picked up. Weeha will claim the cheese.
Liquid are just going to farm as much as they can in between this and the next fight. It's not going to be a lot of time for them, as Mind Control should start backing up already.
He's going to be able to control Jerix, make sure there's going to be no supernova. The tornado is just a bit too late to intercept. And now Team Secret. They know this is their opportunity to end this game. 5 more seconds till the Necrophos is back up. Clearly he's not going to buy back, so they should have a free lane of Rax. The question is Team Secret actually going to stick around? They don't have their Ravage, but they have a huge net worth lead that may be enough confidence for them to be able to take this fight. Mind Control, Time Walks to the side. He's going to be able to get the Chronosphere this time around on Eternal Heavy. The Death Ward gets laid out, but they definitely need the Reaper Scythe. But Eternal Heavy still has that Aegis, so it doesn't even matter. Eternal Heavy now pops the ultimate, turns on a Kuro, starts dealing all those num num stats. He's going to be able to just go through support after support. He's beyond godlike, and they can't even kill him once. But Tumba Man, he comes back in. But the imprisonment is going to stall things up. The tornado controlling some of the heroes in the background. Puppy, with that long-range artillery, is actually keeping Liquid from being able to be aggressive.
They're going to start jumping forward, but Misery...
Misery jumps right back in with the counter-initiation of the Anchor Smash. He's going to be able to stop all this damage. Reaper Scythe goes out. They will be able to kill Weehaw, but still they have to worry about the Slark. His life number two is back up, and Eternal Levy's still feeling pretty healthy. He's fighting this one out.
The
he actually wants to be able to get out here as the Pounce was blocked up, but Tumba Man comes forward. Looks like the Sunray's going to be able to take out Pylai Dai.
Eternal Levy needs
to be able to get into the trees. Hides himself for a second, but Fada, he's a Bloodhound locking down Eternal Levy. They will be able to find him. Team Liquid, they win a fight, but is it too late?
They lost so much out of that double set of racks, but...
A 10k gold swing from that fight.
They had to use the buyback, though, on Matumba Man. And even with a 10k gold swing, it barely brings it up, Cap. The XP is in a similar position. Liquid, they keep the hope alive, but... They've still got a tall mountain to climb, as nobody from Secret have to commit a buyback.
Seems barely a dream at this point. Fada will complete a full Octarine after that fight, but it really seems like he was the only big benefactor of that.
Yeah, the Necrophos having to buy back, and he's had the Shivas for so long.
Jerix almost has a Scythe, but I can't help but wonder if that's actually going to have that big of an impact with the way that Jackie's reacting so quickly. Those Dark Packs and Shadow Dances.
Yeah, they're gonna have to use it on the Outworld Devourer, if anything. And Liquid are getting on the aggressive. They know without the buyback on their main core, they have to make something happen. They can't allow Secret to just reset this fight. They want to try to force buybacks if they can, too. They've got the Chrono available. Puppy's gonna be the frontliner for them. So hard to kill.
Misery? If they want to, they could force the buybacks, but it seems unnecessary. He can make the Blink Ravage initiation, buybacks come in, and they probably win that fight, but at this point in time, it's an unnecessary risk. They want to be able to keep their buybacks intact, and they don't even lose the Tier 3 for it.
Bada's going to have to do everything for Liquid in these fights. The Necro's falling off a little bit too hard.
Okay!
Alright, that's one way to do it.
This is postmodern art at its finest. Eternal Envy, now down to 7 second duration for the BKB.
Still only in the real first misstep of the game for him.
Oh yeah.
I don't think they care too much about that, as if they want, they can just choose to wait it out. Mm-hmm. They've only got one Rex left to contend with, and Team Liquid do not have the best lineup at dealing with Mega Creeps.
All right, there's that side. Liquid, they don't have any items that are gonna be coming in the next 5 minutes that really change this. It seems like their best hope is really now to force a fight.
Yeah. Item timing-wise, this is about perfect for them. But Secret know they haven't gone back to the base yet or anything like that. They've got a ward inside. They're just kind of playing behind this Eternal Envy Slark.
They'll have to eventually. This bottom lane as well as mid are pushing out.
Yeah, they're going to start TPing out now. I don't think that Secret are going to be foolish enough to leave their base in that kind of scenario without vision. Immediately going to counter ward this too. Liquid wanted to fight around that A because it was close to the base, and B, it was the only place on the map that they had offensive ward vision in.
Mm-hmm.
And you almost always want to fight in ward vision if you can help it, especially if you're this far behind.
They've sent back Fada's Invoker, but thanks to the Octarine Core, he can actually join his teammates at top already.
Yeah. And might be a fight that they can take if anybody from Secret continue to push on forward, but Jerix is going to show himself.
Looks like Jackie's just a bit too clever for this routing from Team Liquid. He's going to stick with the five man. And oh, a double damage.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
Arcane rune, double damage. Turtle Envy is a very happy camper now.
Yeah. He hits so hard right now. Liquid, if they see it, they're immediately just going to backpedal.
All right, one more smoke for Liquid. They push out the mid lane, smoke, and try and do a wraparound. It seems like they have to get a surprise initiation. They can't just let Secret 5-man into the base.
No. If they allow Secret to play the siege game, Secret can also just wait for Roshan to be up. And they've got dire advantage plus two lanes of Rax pushing in. And they've got all the map control in the world. There was that brief moment where Liquid were pressing in, but it was because they wanted to try to fight around wards if possible.
Slark is allowing Team Secret to just allow Liquid. It's so dark on the map. In fact, they're going to go for a smoke of their own and looks like go through bottom lane. They could even enter inside the base with this one.
They might even get the high ground advantage.
Vada. Uh-oh, he spots this one out. He's going to immediately pop in DKB. Now the Chrono Trigger turnaround, but they need to follow up. They have the meatball. That's a spicy one. They've got the Sunstrike on Mizray. They're trying to pop him. The Reaper's Scythe. No, it's not going to finish him off. Oh, this egg explodes, but Team Seeker, they're still looking healthy. And now the turnaround comes in. Ravage laid down. They're able to take out already two. And Liquid, they just fall apart after that. They have no buybacks. That was the best possible Chronosphere they could have had, but it just goes to show the Team Secret are just too big to fight up against. They're going to be able to get Fada here after the imprisonment. There's no way the Sunray can save them, and Team Secret will beat down the buildings in preparation of taking game number one.
Yeah, Liquid are going to pop everything that they possibly can, but from the laning phase on, this game has been all Team Secret, especially with that Roche fight. Perfect play by Secret.
Such a superior game by them. They outplayed Liquid every step of the way. Vada starts dropping meatballs, but he's got nothing. He turns around, goes on to Mizray, but he's already dying to Puppy alone. The four position is destroying Vada's Invoker, who's had the highest net worth of Team Liquid for so long. Mizray finally goes down, but the throne explodes, and Team Secret take game one in this grand finals.
What a dominant showing for them, too. We said that Liquid and Secret both got the type of lineups that they wanted. Secret end up on top, psychologically alone.